Here we go.
Hey, everyone. Welcome to the Bud Light Postgame Report. Lee McHugh alongside Mike Milbury and Jeremy Roenick. It was billed as Pittsburgh's offense against Boston's defense, but so far it's simply been a showcase for the Bruins on both ends of the ice. They lead the series 2-0, and they've outscored the Pens 9-1 so far in this series. What have we learned?
We've learned that the Boston Bruins have a foundation. It's based on structure and a system of defense that will be there for them whenever they get in trouble. They fall back into that. And we learned that they can take advantage of that and go into offensive mode. We've learned our Penguins have not found that foundation, and they are a little vulnerable.
They're in trouble. They're big time. And I knew the Boston Bruins were good, but I didn't think that they were this good. Smothering defense, creative offense, powerful hitting, sacrificing themselves to keep the puck out of the net. One of the best teams all the way around from front to back, and one of the best two games I've seen in a long time. They are strong.
You know the story in the first round. The Bruins, about 5 minutes away from elimination. Now, they are 2 wins away from the Stanley Cup Final. Game two, Thomas Fokun getting the start. Marc-Andre Fleury looking over his shoulder. He'd be on the ice pretty soon. We're in the first. We're 28 seconds into the first, and it's Brad Marchand breaking the ice.
The entire tone and complexion of this hockey game changed in the first half minute, and Marchand gets the glove on the puck and beats Fokun cleanly. He didn't look too good on that one. Bruins now in control.
Tuukka Rask was a story in game one, 29 saves, a shutout, good early.
Yeah, he didn't have to make too many saves, but had a good save early, and McGinley misses the rebound.
More from the Boston offense, Nathan Horton off the rebound. Torrey Krug picks up an assist, that made it 2-0. Still in the first period, David Krejci continues his torrid pace, his eighth of the postseason off some pretty passing.
Incredible, between the legs from Lucic right here, you'll see it coming up. To Horton, who finds an undefended Krejci. Aginla, you got to find your man.
And that was it for Thomas Fokun. Marc-Andre Fleury came in. As for Pittsburgh, looking for a little bit of a spark, Brandon Sutter, his second of this postseason, that made it 3-1.
33 seconds left. It was the only thing that the Pittsburgh fans had to cheer about. But it wouldn't last for long.
No, not at all. Just 25 seconds later, Brad Marchand, he started the period, and this is how he ended it.
Matt Cook got tangled up here with Marchand. Instead of paying attention to where the puck was, he lost it. Marchand off to the races, and he fires this one easily past Fleury. And then he goes back at Cook right away, say, what do you got? What do you got for me?
I'm surprised he would do that, Brad Marchand. That doesn't seem like him at all. We go to the third period. Patrice Bergeron, everything's going right for Boston right now. This snapped a six-game goal drought.
How about the pass by Jaromir Jagr? Backhand right onto a stick of Bergeron. Empty netter. And Boston sends the Pittsburgh fans home packing, not too happy, and neither is Sidney Crosby.
Two home games, two home losses for Pittsburgh. Boston leads the series 2-0. They take this one down 6-1. Brad Marchand doubles his goal total in this playoffs with a pair of first period goals. And afterwards, he chatted with Pierre McGuire.
How would you describe your first two games here in Pittsburgh?
We're obviously very happy with the outcome. We knew it was going to come in. We were going to come in. It's going to be very tough games. They're very fast, very skilled. And, I think we got a little lucky. Tuukka bailed us out in both games, so we just got to make sure we play a little better next game.
Your play to start this game was unbelievable with Crosby back, bouncing puck. What's going through your mind when you got a chance to separate Sidney Crosby from the puck and going on a breakaway?
Well, I know he's obviously very fast, so I was just trying to make sure I skated as hard as I could. And I got down there and a couple sticks on me, and I just wanted to shoot and make sure I got a shot off, and happy it went in.
You took a penalty on Crosby, and Jaromir Jagr came over and put his arm around you. What was he saying to you?
He's always got some friendly advice. Just make sure you stay smart, and we don't want to give him any momentum, so you just want to make sure that that wasn't going to happen, and the guys did a great job of killing that off.
Todd, Brad, has anything surprised you about this series so far?
Yeah, I think, it's so back and forth. I mean, the energy throughout the whole game, they're so fast, and they can really create something out of nothing. And it just seems like you're always going to be on your toes, and something's going to happen every shift, and it's very exciting.
Is anything Tuukka Rask is doing surprise you?
Yeah, you don't expect him to come in and play as good as he has. I mean, it's a very tough thing to do. To play that way against the Penguins. But hopefully we continue to get the lucky bounces, and he keeps playing that way.
There was a lot of energy in this building to start the game. Obviously, you took the energy out of it. What do you expect the energy to be like when you touch the ice in Boston for game three?
It's always very exciting back home. We got an incredible fan base, and we're always very excited to play at home in front of them, and they give us so much momentum. So hopefully we can use that to our advantage.
Thanks for your time, brother.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
So they call him the little ball of hate, and you want him to play with energy, and you want him to play with an edge. But even when things are going well, how much, if you're his teammate or if you're his coach, do you have to monitor him throughout the game?
Without question, because he plays the game at such a high level, but high-strung level, and there are times that Marchand can actually hurt you instead of help you. And tonight he did a little bit of both, but he was very creative, especially defensively. I think they're trying to really make sure that he stays poised defensively. Nice play right there, knocking the puck off. Look at the strength, stealing the puck from Neil, and even though Neil gets back and pushes him down, still stays with it and gets back into play. Here's where he can hurt you. Taking a penalty on Sidney Crosby. And look, this is the essence of a good team. Jágr coming over and say, guy, we can't give him any momentum. Even Doug Huda in the locker room, we can't do that. Marchand, what does he do? He comes right back and plays the same start of hard style that makes him that little ball of hate. Matt Cook, another ball of hate, going at each other. Matt Cook trying to stir the pot. Marchand stays out of it, stays disciplined, gets into the rush, and buries one late in the second period, looks at Cook and says, What do you got? Who's better now? See you next game. And that was a great way to end the game for Marchand. Very humble in his interview, but still, they know they have to play better in coming back home.
When teams are in this sort of situation that Pittsburgh is in, we try to draw something that they've done well that they can use going forward. With L.A., they're down 2-0. They can play physical. They can play hard. They've done that at times. For Pittsburgh, you search. What do you find?
Not a single solitary thing. Not one. This is an embarrassment for them. In fact, this is really basically a comedy of errors. You couldn't believe that a team with this talent level would look like this. Look at the behind-the-back pass to a Boston Bruin from Sidney Crosby, one of the best players, if not the best player in the world. Watch this one. Collisions galore amongst one another. Who's got it? I mean, nobody seems to be in control here. Dead giveaway right in front of your net. Clumsy, falling all over each other. This is a team that's banging into each other. I can't believe that you're watching this from the Pittsburgh Penguins. Turnovers, anything that a coach's nightmare could consist of, falling down, being tripped by your own players. You know what? It'll put your fans to sleep. And this next guy got dressed to come to a party. He's at a vivisection of a penguin. So that's the end of the story.
That guy's got to get up in the morning, put his business suit on, and go to work. It's depressing for them. You heard Brad Marchand. He was talking about Tuukka Rask. Came up big again. So far, he has allowed just one goal on 56 shots in this series. Coming up, we will hear from Claude Julien as the Bud Light postgame report continues after this.